It's always good to know someone's journey. Could you talk about how you found yourself on the eastern shore of Maryland?
I was born and raised in Istanbul, Turkey. And I moved to the States, to Chicago, to attend the University of Chicago, where I met my spouse, who is an Ottoman historian. And when he finished his PhD, he got a job at Salisbury University. And we moved from Chicago to Salisbury. And we've been here for about 3 years now. Yeah.
Salisbury, last time I checked, was not looking like Chicago.
You know, it really grew on us because the Eastern Shore, Salisbury and the Eastern Shore in general, because I think both my spouse and I, we've both grown up in huge cities. I mean, Istanbul is 16 million and counting right now. And it was a really interesting change of pace to move to a smaller town and get to know all the things that it actually offered.
And kind of your first job on the ground, as I understand it, was helping with Salisbury University's visual arts programs.
I was an education and outreach program coordinator for the Salisbury University Art Galleries. They also have a remarkable permanent collection, especially of American photography. So I was, you know, fortunate to do a lot of programming around that. And I was also teaching as an adjunct at Anne Arundel Community College.
Why photography?
It's a very special medium. I often am able to trace my interest to, again, my upbringing in Istanbul, where there was a lot of polarity. I could perceive a lot of subdued disconnect around me, you know, modernization and heritage, history and future, and so on. And photography is one of those mediums that have an ability to really conjure a gray area. You know, it does present what has been, as photography critic Roland Barthes writes in Camera Lucida, but also it really can be anything you want it to be in terms of context and content. So I'm really, really interested in that.
What I think is interesting is photography has now come into its own. You know, it used to be the poor cousin in the world of art. The newcomer is probably a better way of putting it. And now it's turned out to be quite a mature segment.
Yeah, David Hockney, I think, called it a paralyzed cyclops. You would only make photographs if you wanted what, you know, the worldview of a paralyzed cyclops, because that's what the camera is. I think there's a really tactile quality to a good print. So I think the fact that we are now celebrating and appreciating good prints and photography as an art form and its sort of relationship to truthiness is very, very valuable.
And I would be interested to find out what made this position appealing to you. What was the hook?
The hook was having this incredible resource that I could work with. I've always been interested in curatorial work. And I was, again, I had the privilege of curating a number of shows and jury some others, both at Salisbury and on the Eastern Shore. And I think there's really a very rewarding aspect to bringing art that can really broaden horizons and make viewers think differently about context and content. I'm also very community minded. I am interested in working with an incredible educational and development team at the Academy, who do so much to bring people into the museum and to see these really historically very significant works.
What did you want to do when you thought it was going to be a traditional world? And how have you been able to adjust to this new situation we're in?
That's actually a great question. I think museums are always changing. So even without major calamity that, you know, influences all aspects of our lives negatively, we're still always trying to transform, always trying to engage with what's new in the field. And museums are becoming increasingly accessible online. you know, we're always thinking about how to reach more people. And I think when I started, I was aware of sort of this role of both connecting to the museum's existing plans on that, as well as the physical exhibitions, and trying to, you know, organize things using my own voice after that. But I think now our, you know, obviously the museum is closed to the public. So, you know, we're at this point where we have to make sure that we are able to present all of the resources that we've acquired for exhibitions once we reopen. A good example is what we're doing with our juried photography show. We were slated to open it on April 24th for our grand reopening. And now we can't. So what we're doing is, until we can fulfill our commitment to present the physical show, we're going to take it online so that people can enjoy and celebrate the selected artists. Trying to look at art on the internet is lacking a certain element of aura, right? Being in presence of a great piece, a masterpiece, is, you know, you can't conjure that on a screen. But while that's true, I think there are a lot of other ways that online engagement with works can be rewarding. One thing we're doing at the museum is we have an Art of the Week competition where artists in the community are asked to look at one of our pieces from our permanent collection and then make work in response to the week's theme. So we're trying to enrich and expand on how that sort of almost fleeting moment with the work on a screen can be expanded.
Thank you for participating in this.
I really appreciate this.